And we're going to get you filled with protein so you can make it all the way through the show without having to nap if you're trying to make your burgers healthier this summer. Skip the bun. Swap the ground beef for salmon.
Here to show us how to make salmon burgers is Cindy Barbieri from cindystable.com. Nice to have you here.
Oh, it's always great to be here, and I'm so excited to share this recipe with you. And, of course, I got the fish at City Fish in Wethersfield. They have the best seafood department, and Telly, who was one of the owner's son, he actually took the skin off for me.
And so that's what we want to ask for if we're going to get it on our own. Ask people to take the skin off for you.
Yeah, take the skin off for you. They'll do it for you, and it's one less thing you have to do, one less thing to put in your garbage. So I love doing that.
That's
and
awesome.
They're actually really happy to do that for you. They really want to do that for you. So we're going to make a healthy, this is actually a paleo version of a salmon burger. So we have our food processor, so everything goes in there, so which is really nice as well.
So paleo, it's nothing's processed,
nothing
right?
is processed. Okay. Everything's natural. We're not using any processed food. So I bought a pound of salmon, a pound and a half, to make four good-sized burgers. So we're just going to start by putting the salmon right into the food processor.
Right in there.
Right in there. So I just, you know, cut it up in, you know, manageable pieces to do this. Now, what I do at home is I actually grind it up and make a little one for my dog, Jake.
Nice. Well, you got to have, you know, petite
so
salmon.
So Jake needs to have a salmon burger, so I do start grinding it up and make it plain. And then for us, we add the ingredients. So, Seth, I was going to ask you if you can just, you know, chop up a little bit of scallions
sure.
for us. And then we're going to add in the other ingredients.
Yep, so let you move in
oh,
here.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're good at chopping.
So I'm just going to add in a little bit of salt and pepper.
Okay.
And then, Ash, if you want to help with the other, we have almond flour. Almond meal, and that's just going to help us bind it.
You need the almond meal?
Yeah, we're going to add that into the food processor
okay.
as well. So
we
maybe Seth can
I'm on the case.
I want it to help,
right
but
in?
I just can't reach.
Right in there, and I just added in some cayenne pepper. I like a little bit of heat.
Me too.
So it just a little bit extra. I, you know,
yeah.
Extra, you know. Now we have.
Do the scallions go in?
Right in there. That's
okay.
perfect.
Oh, so. I didn't have to do such a thorough
scallions.
Job.
No, I like them a little thinner because just so they do get ground up really nice. Now I have some about a couple of tablespoons of mayonnaise. Now I have a paleo mayonnaise recipe on my blog, or mm-hmm. you can buy your favorite mayonnaise, low fat, all fat, whatever you want to do. We have a little bit of Dijon mustard here. Mm-hmm. And then and Seth, if you want to add in about a teaspoon or so of horseradish. Now, I love the horseradish. It gives it
Ooh.
Some.
Yeah.
It does give it great flavor. You can add lemon juice if you want as well.
Clears out your sinuses.
But add that right in there.
And it's going to get mixed
and
in and everything.
That's
so
it.
It's not going to
Watch
be.
This. We're
that's
gonna
it.
Put the food processor on and we're just going to mix it up.
That's what you need. There you go.
Look at this, how easy this is. Now we just
All
take
right.
the cover off. Now, what I do at home sometimes is I'll actually make the burgers. Put them on a plate, wrap it with Saran wrap, and put it in the refrigerator for about 30 minutes. It just helps, you know, form the burger and mm-hmm. keep it easier when you're cooking it. But we're going to go right ahead and cook it. So I have my cast iron pan on a medium-high heat.
Okay.
How long do you want to preheat it for? That's really key, is making sure you have a nice hot pan,
You do.
Right?
You want the pan nice and hot. Now, because we're keeping this nice and healthy, we're using coconut oil.
Okay. Just
and
a smidge?
Just, you know, enough to coat the bottom. So maybe a tablespoon or so.
Okay.
And we'll let that melt
there we
up.
Go.
So we'll get that in there. You can add a little bit more.
Sure.
Seth, we'll add a little bit more in there. So we have that going, and that won't take very long at all to melt. Now, what I like to do, because I don't want to stick my hands in the food processor
yeah, like you.
And make a big mess. I'm not all about the mess. So what I do is I grab an ice cream scoop. So as big as you want them. So if you want sliders or bigger burgers, and then I'm going to pop it right into the cast iron pan and then just flatten it.
Perfect.
So I'm not worried about touching anything. I'm not making a mess. And I'm not putting it into a bowl to dirty another bowl.
And they're all going to be about the same size,
And they're all going to be the same size, right. So again, I'm just going to add them right in there.
Now, how long do you need them to cook on each side?
So these cook about 5 minutes each side. They cook really fast. And if you want to bake them at 350, 10 minutes, that's perfect as well. Now, you can't really make these on your grill outside because it'll fall apart. But a nice cast iron pan works great. And if you want to cook them on your grill, you can bring the cast iron pan onto your grill.
Oh,
that's
there
true. You can
you
heat
go.
Up the pan really well
You can
on the grill.
Heat up the pan on the grill, so this way you don't have to have, if you're worried about the salmon smell in your house, so you can light a candle.
Well, and for those hot summer days, when the last thing you want to do is be on your stovetop, it's a perfect idea.
Well, you know, we have our lake house, and we cook everything out in the grill. We don't
you have
cook
to.
Anything out in the house, because I don't want the mess in the house.
Now, fast forward about 10 minutes,
so
and we've
about
got
10 minutes.
These.
Now, we have them already done, so if you want to hand me that plate right there, Seth, I'll just put one on a on a plate for us.
Okay.
Now, I made an aioli. Now, the aioli is right next to you, Ashley.
Oh, that's a fancy term for mayonnaise.
Aioli's yesterday.
Yes.
There you go.
Now, that is basically all the ingredients that we put into the salmon burgers. So what I like to do is add a little dot onto the salmon burgers.
Okay.
Here you go.
Some red onion.
Just a dollop?
Yep. On each one. Now, what I do at home is I actually will make a nice salad.
Mm-hmm.
And we eat these every Sunday night. My husband and I make these. on a salad with some red onion and Hayo's dinner. So if you guys want to try them, because the fish is just amazing.
Right here. Ashley, you want to garnish it like a restaurant professional?
Yeah, you can add some red onions to it. Okay. The red onion and the aioli with the salmon burgers just is amazing. It's a great taste. And everything we put in there just adds so much more flavor to the already perfect salmon.
That's true. And it's a nice, healthy recipe,
too. It's a healthy recipe.
Okay.
That's good.
Is that good?
Seth is loving it. So good. Thank you so much, Cindy.
Oh, my pleasure.
Love being in the kitchen with you. And later on, we're going to make some tater tots to go with our burgers. And the special thing is that they're sweet potato tater tots. Say that three times fast.
I'm not going to try.
No, you don't have to.
Let's make Jennifer Pie try.
Oh.
We're back with Cindy Barbary, CindyTables.com. Now we're making tater tots to go along with our salmon cakes, but they're not your grandma's tater tots.
No, these are great, and they're healthy. Again, we're sticking with the paleo theme today. Now, I have sweet potatoes. Seth, if you want to grab the fork, all you have to do is just, you know, give it a few
just pokes. Get some aggression out.
Yeah, get some aggression out. Now, what I like to do is cover my baking sheet with foil. So easy cleanup. We just throw the foil away and put the pan away.
Oh, my kind of girl.
So
that's
nice and clean. So 375 for about 45 minutes. We want them to get nice and soft. Now, if you don't have 45 minutes, pop them in the microwave, a few holes.
Really?
7 minutes, done.
Okay.
So 45 in the oven or 7 minutes in your microwave.
Oh, or not both.
Or,
okay,
right. What I usually do is do 4 minutes and then put them in for a few more minutes up until about 7 minutes.
Okay.
So we let them cool for a little bit, want them nice and cool. We take the skins off, and this is what we get. We have the inside of two sweet potatoes.
Easy, very easy.
Very easy. Now, all we need to do is add in salt and pepper.
Just a pinch.
Mix it together, and that's all we need to do. Now, I like to add some other flavors. So here we have some red pepper flakes, Italian seasoning, onion powder.
Okay,
use whatever you want. If you want to do, you can do cumin. You can add whatever you're going with. So if you have, you know, if you're cooking something using other spices, add those in there.
Okay.
You know, I could even, you know, add some of the ingredients that we put in from the salmon burgers, too, to keep them all the same. So, you know, use your imagination, whatever you want.
Okay.
Now, that's all we need to do. Now, I have a nice cast iron pan that I have on a medium-high heat, want it nice and heat, nice and hot.
Okay. Start with a hot pan.
Very hot pan. And we're going to add in some coconut oil, just like we did earlier. Nice and
right.
Healthy. And actually, the coconut oil really gives the sweet potato an extra flavor, which is really nice that I like.
Well, because the sweet potato has this almost sugary taste, and then so many people use coconut in sweet things. I feel like it's a really sweet treat we're making.
It really is nice. So you want it coated because the sweet the potato will stick to the pan. So you want a nice level of oil.
Okay.
Now, what I do, now you can make these any shape you want.
Well, so I want the tot.
Yeah.
So what I do is I get 2 teaspoons.
Okay.
Okay.
It's like making gnocchi.
So you get a, and you just kind of go back and forth.
Oh.
And you kind of create the shape you want. To me, this is the easiest way to do it. So you just go back and forth, and then you just plop it into your pan.
Whatever kind of shape you want.
Whatever shape you want.
Gnocchi.
And this is something great to do with your kids.
Oh,
you know, the
yeah.
kids would just love to sit at the counter and make these. I know my granddaughter, Brooke, would love to do this with me. So we just continue going.
Sure. These it's adult, healthy Play-Doh.
It really is. And you know, if you serve these to your friends, they're going to love them with your healthy salmon burger.
But you could use your hands if you wanted to roll a little
ball. If you want to use your hands, if you have a melon scoop, you can use a melon scoop. So you can really use anything you want. So, of course, I have some made over here.
Fast forward to the finished
product. To the finished product.
I got to get myself some tater, sweet potato.
So here, give those a try. And I'll continue cooking these up.
Put them right with
but they're nice and healthy. Now, again, we could, you know, I'm using the fry method here. But you can put them in your oven at 400 degrees on parchment paper and do the same thing. Maybe drizzle some oil on top just to give it that nice flavor.
Perfect side dish for your salmon burgers or really anything you make this season.
Anything you make. And you can make these in advance and then just warm them up before your guests come.
So
you don't have to be cooking while your guests are visiting you.
Thank you so much.
Oh, thank you for having me.
My mass appeal.